A tropical Hawaiian getaway for only $129.99.
Oh, great. That's exactly how much I have saved up.
Well, you don't actually go to Hawaii. You go to Albany.
Oh.
But the bus you're on is Hawaiian themed. The driver's wearing a grass skirt, Don Ho music, and all the canned pineapple you can eat.
We should do that.
Oh, my God.
It's all day.
Claude, about the White House Correspondents Dinner this weekend?
Yes. Your hotel is booked, your plane tickets are taken care of, and I told the limo driver, Phil Collins, and plenty of it.
Well, get ready to sing along with me, because you're coming, too.
Thank you. Thank you so much. I promise I will not let you down, sir.
I like that sir thing. Maybe try that in D.C.?
Congratulations, honey.
Well, it's no Hawaii, but then neither was that other thing.
Oh, this is so exciting. I finally get to blow up my travel pillow.
Well, don't get too excited. GMB business trips are as dull as they get. Except when I'm going. Finally. Every year they take that Gil Longo. But now they've come to their senses and realized that I, not Gil, am the more efficient researcher.
Right. Well, Gil did die, Lydia.
Oh, Washington. Where did I put my push-up bra? Yeah, I'm wearing it! Oh, don't pout. It's not like everyone's going.
Oh, yeah? Check out this email. Hey, Kipp, could you please cover for me the week of the 7th while I'm in D.C.? Hugs, Colleen, the office nurse.
Hey, you know what would be fun?
What?
You coming over tonight and helping me hang my shower curtain.
Ramona, you know I hate new shower curtain smell.
So do I. That's why you're hanging it. After a plateful of my shrimp Diablo.
Diablo should have been your headline, baby.
Here are the time cards for the cafeteria, Ramona.
They're always late, sometimes they're sticky, and today they have shreds of... What is that?
Pork. What's up, bro?
It's all good.
Hey, you guys want to go up to the helipad and chuck gravy balloons at the newscopter?
We'd love
to. Can't do that. Owen's got inventory, and I've got accounts payable.
Holy man, do your job sound boring. Yeah, I'll see you at lunch.
Carl's cool, isn't he?
Carl's trouble.
Oh, come on. He's just a guy like me.
Okay, guy. Who won the Super Bowl last year?
Nice try. Super Bowl was this year.
They put me in the executive junior mini suite, and it is gorgeous. And the closet light comes on when you open the door. It's amazing. So if you could just send up that club sandwich and those towels, that'd be great. What are you doing in my room?
Well, according to the clerk at the front desk, we're roommates.
What? Isn't there anything you can do?
No, he's gay. And the hotel is sold out.
Well, at least there are two beds.
Oh, the luxury. This is outrageous. It's like, what's his face in travel doesn't even know who I am.
Oh, come on. Everybody knows who you are. You're the bitch from 22.
Don't try and make me feel better.
Oh, hey, Carl, what are you doing up here?
There's no room in the cafeteria for an office, so, you know, I do my paperwork wherever I can. Actually, I was using the meat locker for a little while, but I can only do it for 10 minutes at a time.
Fingers freeze up?
No, I've just never been able to concentrate for more than 10 minutes. I need a break. So, Hancho, what do you say you and I head over to Carmine's Ristorante tonight, put our names down?
Yeah, sure.
We give free wine to people on their wait list. Free wine, free wine, free wine. When they call our names, we bolt.
See ya.
Then I got two free subway passes because I faked a turnstile injury. Oh. We ride the trains for a little while, clear our heads.
Oh, yeah, because we're going to need to do that.
Then we crash a frat party at NYU. Yeah. Free beer, free beer, free beer. When they ask us our majors, we bolt.
Yeah. I'm in. Oh, except I already told Ramona I'd help her hang a shower curtain.
Dude, that better be a euphemism for something else.
And never was before.
Well, then cancel, Monsieur Wuss.
You're right, Sergeant Steam Tray. I deserve to be out in the streets with my buddy, not in some chick's bathroom hanging plastic. Oh, I could see how you could take that the wrong way.
Where am I supposed to put my stuff?
You're right, I'm sorry. I'll call down and get you a locker at the health club.
Lydia, we're in the nation's capital, the cradle of democracy, okay? So in this room, we are equals, which means that I get to put my toothbrush on top of something other than the toilet.
Fine. But a democracy has laws, so if you snore, you have to put one of those tapey things over your nose. Or I'll put one of those pillowy things over your face.
I don't normally snore, but now I'll make every effort to.
I decided to pay my own way. I mean, obviously, there's been some oversight if they send a low-class plebeian like Claude. Oh, hi, Claude. As I was saying, there's obviously been some oversight if they send a low-class plebeian like Claude instead of me. But don't you worry. We're going to get you a cot.
I'm not worried because you are not staying.
Whoa. Remember democracy? All those in favor of Kip staying in this room, raise their hands.
Okay, fine. But get ready, people, because I am going to snore like a buzzsaw.
A whole hotel room to herself. Claude must be having the best time.
Yep. Just being by yourself for an evening, that can be a lot of fun for a lady.
So, should we cab it back to my place together?
Yeah, sure. I'll ride with you. I made plans with Carl. Whenever you're ready.
Whoa. You made plans with me, and then you made plans with Carl?
Yeah, but there's very good reason. You see, I want to do the stuff that he wants to do, and I don't want to do the stuff that you want to do.
What kind of stuff does he want to do?
Oh, you know, waiting in restaurants, riding the subway. It's not going to sound exciting to you.
Fine. Then you go do your thing with him instead of me and have a good time.
Okay. And you're not mad?
No, I'm not mad.
Then why am I so scared?
Because I'm pissed off!
Now, we're all anchors. Some of us are on network news. Some of us are on in Phoenix, Milwaukee. I forget. But we share a common bond. We all spend some time doing the weather. God, I'm disappointing. That's what I'm talking about. You guys are good.
Well, I've been riding since I was 8 years old. My father had horses. Mother didn't want me to ride, but I just had to. You're really drunk, aren't you? Okay, Senator, I'll be back after you've had some bread.
Lydia, isn't this cool?
I just tried a raw oyster for the first time.
Really? And how did you like it?
It was okay. It's in the ashtray over there. Oh, and another first for me. I just got invited to the White House Correspondents Dinner. She said, all cool and nonchalant, even though she is super psyched.
Oh, you got invited to that. Well, I'm glad I'm not going. Watch where you're going.
Irene Przybowski? Is that you?
I'm Lydia Weston. You must have me confused with someone else. I have no idea who this Rini Przybowski is.
Rini, it is you. Joni Scalanti. Hojo? I used to live above the deli where you worked. Could you just... Hey, you got the snaggletooth fixed.
Oh, me, Lydia Weston. I'll be right there.
So you Oh. So much better now.
Oh, hey, Ramona. Did you hang that shower curtain?
No, I'm not tall enough. My arms get tired, and I wanted you to do it.
I know, I'm sorry. Now you probably like Carl even less.
I couldn't like Carl any less.
You know, you really haven't had the opportunity to get to know him. You know, I think it would be so great if we all hung out together.
I don't know if it'd be great, but maybe sometime.
Sometime? Sometime like right now. Carl!
What's going on?
Meet our new office mate. What an opportunity!
For a double homicide.
Look, he's going to be on his best behavior, right?
I can also provide you with a complimentary continental breakfast every morning.
Now, what exactly is that? Coffee, muffin, croissant, half a melon?
Yeah.
Okay, that'll work. But remember, this is an office, my office. We're professionals here.
Yes.
Yeah, loud and clear.
We can hear you. Yes, ma'am.
All right, then. What's so funny?
Hey.
One more time. And this arrangement is over. All right, I'm done.
No.
Ramona.
Come on, Ramona. Please stop this.
Finally, where have you been all day?
Well, last night you just fell asleep, and then this morning I realized that you were actually unconscious. And then, well, at lunch, I thought you were dead. But I found a pulse, so I decided to do some sightseeing.
Who have you told? Oh.
Everyone here knows, Lydia.
It's over.
Everybody knows that I paid my own way. But you know what? It's money well spent because I love D.C. Even in a town full of rich, powerful men, the ladies still flock to me. I guess it's because I'm clean and I'm not too threatening. I met a particularly lovely socialite who begged me to have dinner with her tonight. And after that, if all goes well, and she wants to come back up to the room, well, you just wait for my signal.
And what would that be?
When you come in, if I am on top of her, leave.
You didn't tell him. Oh, this is good. He would destroy me.
Oh, Lydia, was your childhood really that bad?
Yes, it was wretched beyond description. Tract houses on a street where the trees weren't even mature. We had an above-ground pool and a mailbox that looked like a miniature of our house.
Oh, for God's sake, Lydia.
You don't get it.
No.
This was the kind of place where the kids at school would yell out things like, "Hey, Snaggletooth, can you open my can of beer?" It was awful.
Awful. You want to know awful? Awful is spending the last year and a half being constantly made to feel inferior to you, when in fact, we pretty much had the exact same childhood, only, well, I had perfect teeth.
Whatever. We've got a deal here, right? You're not going to tell Kipp.
No, I don't recall making any deals. I do recall somebody taking all the hangers.
You can't tell him.
Oh, I can do whatever I want. I can tell people your secret, not tell people your secret, tell people you have a secret, but not tell them what it is, tell them the secret, but just not tell them it's you. Torture's fun.
Well, torture me if you want to, but Lydia Weston is a survivor because I created her, and I don't create fictional characters that aren't survivors.
Okay, well, I have a gala to attend, so if you'll excuse me, I'm about to meet the President of the United States. Oh,
Maybe I'll tell him. Hey! Do you want to borrow my conditioner?
Somebody's pretty dressed up to come down, get ice, then go back to the room and watch pay-per-view.
On the contrary, Kipp, I have already had a fascinating evening, and now I'm topping it off by going to the correspondents' dinner.
Oh, well, how nice for you. Oh, look, there's my date.
Hojo?
Hojo? What is that, some kind of voodoo curse you just put on me?
No. She's your date?
Yeah.
Interesting.
Hi, Joni. Thanks for being on time.
Hi, Kipp. Don't you look nice? Hey, aren't you Renee's friend? Do you guys all work together?
Renee? Who's Renee?
Irene Przybylski. She's this girl I know from back home, but she changed her name to... Okay, look. This conversation is over right now.
Why?
Because. He's mine. Stay away from him. Walk it off. Just walk it off. That's what I'm gonna do.
So, how are you? Haven't seen you around. You look good.
You don't.
You know, you really should have stuck it out down there. We're having a blast.
Is that so?
Oh, yeah, we're having a great time. Get him out of the office.
So you finally tired of all the roughhousing and the rowdiness?
Well, that and the blood in my urine.
I thought about warning you, but you had to learn it on your own. And now you know there's a reason guys' night out is only one night a week. So you ready to come home now?
Carry me.
I lied. My date wasn't a socialite, and she didn't cancel because she got sick.
You woke me up for that.
Claude kissed me. She kissed me long, and she kissed me hard.
What?
My date comes over, and she starts asking Claude about some girl named Rennie or Renee or somebody who works at G&B, and the next thing I know, Claude is on me like a raccoon on a can of beans. You keep her away from me. I'm locking the door.
Did you have fun at your dinner?
Yeah, it was amazing. I met the president, and Will met Phil Collins.
Claude, thank you.
You owe me big time.
You gone scrub that desk good, Carl. Oh, and I still smell vinegar on this phone.
Look, you got carried away. I'm sorry, and I take full responsibility. What?
Nothing.
Nothing.
I think we got a file door wide open.
Where? Under there.
Under where?
There you go.
Oh,
That's great, yeah.
No.
Yeah, sure, whatever.
Serious.
Real nuts.